Before we start, can I indicate to members that we have time in hand this afternoon? It's likely that we are going to go to the debate after topical question time early. So I'm hoping, I'm assuming, indeed I'm expecting that people will be in the chamber for the start of that debate. Topical questions. Question one, Sarah Boyack.
To ask the Scottish Government how it is supporting the farming sector to transition to the new rural payments and services system.
Cabinet Secretary Richard Lockhead.
There can be no doubt that the new Common Agricultural Policy is extremely complex, and we worked alongside the industry to carefully plan the implementation, which is now underway. To support the transition, we took a number of steps. We held over 50 farmer meetings to explain the new policy. That reached 6,500 people in the last 5 months. Our online single application form delivering the new cap was launched on time, and farmers can book customer support sessions in our 16 area offices, of which 437 farmers have done so far. And farmers without good broadband at home can also access our online services in an area office. As with all new websites, we are aware of teething issues that some customers have been experiencing. We have fixed many of these and are working hard to address the remaining ones quickly. However, it's worth noting that the system has been available 97% of the time. The online service has major benefits in helping farmers avoid errors and penalties with its built-in checks and validation. I would therefore encourage all farmers to register and use the service.
Sarah Boyack.
Can I thank the Cabinet Secretary for his answer and agree that the system is hugely important and welcome the intentions behind the system? Can I say, though, that I understand that the online process has been painstakingly slow and deeply frustrating for those attempting to use it, and that there are particular problems for farmers with dyslexia given the complexity of the process? It was reported on Friday, Cabinet Secretary, that 150 out of an expected 22,000 farmers and crofters had actually started the process online. And as the system is crucial for cap payments, it's fundamental that it's fixed, but it appears to be a shambles at the moment. Given the concerns that have been raised by the NFUS Cabinet Secretary, when will the system be fixed, and what would be the implications if the Scottish Government were to take up Commissioner Hogan's offer for Member States to extend the SAF deadline?
Cabinet Secretary.
Thank you. Can I just say that, of course, the system has only been open, the online system, for 1 week and 1 day. And given the complexity of the new policy, we were always aware that the first week of the new system, perhaps even the first 2 weeks of the new system, would throw up some issues that have to be ironed out. The number of farmers who complete the forms online is always very low in the first few weeks of the window being opened. And of course, they have until May the 15th. So we are addressing all these issues as arise. I think it's completely unfair and unreasonable to say it's a shambles. That simply talks us into a place I don't think any of us want to be in, and will sow seeds of uncertainty across the industry. So I'd ask members to, yes, we recognise, of course, there are issues that have to be ironed out, but ask members to keep their comments measured, because we want people to have confidence that they can apply for these vital payments under the new policy. But I would point out that, unlike elsewhere on these islands, in Scotland, people can apply using paper or online, and they have that option. And in terms of people who are having difficulties or challenges, they can visit the local area office and get assistance for completing either online or using paper. There is a wide variety of support available across the country to help farmers and crofters complete these forms, and I would urge all farmers to take advantage of the support that is available. In terms of farmers who may have dyslexia, I think that was mentioned in Sarah Boyack's question. Again, I would urge anyone who has such challenges to visit their area office and sit with one of the officials and get advice in terms of how to use online the system or complete a paper copy. That assistance is available for people to use. And finally, in terms of the question of extending the SAF, that's a single application form deadline, beyond the 15th of May for one further month, as Commissioner Hogan last week said, is an option that Member States can voluntarily take up if they so wish. We are currently considering what the consequences would be of taking up that offer. We're not ruling it out, but we do recognise that if we extend the deadline of applications by 1 month, it cuts the amount of time we have for inspections before we make payments by 1 month as well. And of course, we have to discuss with stakeholders the consequences of doing that, given that the farmers and crofters are saying to me, what's really important is to get the payments out as quickly as possible once the window for that opens in December. So please, rest assured, we are treating these matters very seriously.
Sarah Blake.
Can I thank the seriousness with which the Cabinet Secretary has addressed the issue I've raised? I totally agree we don't want to exacerbate the problem, but could the Cabinet Secretary just clarify when the technical problems with the online process will be fixed and people can have confidence in the system?
Cabinet Secretary.
Yes, and it's a very important issue, because I'm not doubting for 1 second that it will be extremely frustrating for those who have gone online during the few occasions where the system has been down. The fixes have been put in place quickly. There are some remaining. For instance, the industry asked for a printing facility, so once they've populated the data on their forms, they can print out and perhaps keep a copy to refer to in paper format, and we are hopefully introducing that facility within a few days at the request of the industry. But as I reiterated, this is a very complex system, and the fact we do now have a functioning online system available which brings additional benefits to completing it on paper. In other words, the validation process online flags up problems to the applicant immediately, which they can then fix online, unlike with the paper copies, and that avoids penalties and avoids future problems further down the road. And that's a very important dynamic in the online system that we have invested in. So I will continue to take these issues seriously, and we'll make sure that any other issues that do arise are fixed as quickly as possible.
Alex Ferguson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I've been listening very carefully to what the Cabinet Secretary said, and I understand his desire to keep the language measured here, but we are talking here of a system that an increasing number of agents, people who are well-versed in filling in these forms online and on paper, are calling not fit for purpose. An agent who I know well, who is used to completing these forms, tells me that the SAF system crashed on him 14 times on day 3, but 7 times yesterday as well. He finally completed a simple online form for a small farming business this morning, and he was given an application receipt number of 53. Does that mean that at this point in time, only 53 farming businesses have completed the process? As has already been said, DEFRA have extended the deadlines for submissions, but they've also issued pre-populated information paper forms to every farmer to ensure that European deadlines are met. Can I ask the Cabinet Secretary whether the Scottish Government will be prepared to do the same if necessary? And if not, what is its alternative plan B, if it has one? And if it has one, which I hope it has, when is the cut-off point that that plan B will have to be put into action?
We do have contingency plans in Scotland. Indeed, that was referred to with the coverage of what's happened with the English system in the last few days, where it was pointed out that, unlike in England, Scotland does have contingency plans. And that, of course, that does involve paper copies of the single application form if required. But, of course, they're already available for specific requests. If any farmer wants to use paper, they can do that at the moment. They don't have to apply online. So I don't doubt for a second the frustrations caused by those occasions where the system has been shut down over the first week of it being set up. What I am saying to the Chamber is that every effort has been made to fix any issues that come to their attention as quickly as possible. Many of them have been fixed already. And indeed, one agent, Ian Hope, at CKD Galbraith's Perth office said, I have not completed a full SAF yet, but I have been filling in full data sheets and it seems to be working okay. I would rather be working online than on paper. If we have to go back to paper as they have in England, it will just increase the scope for errors because there will be no automatic checks. Now that we are online, we have to keep the momentum going. I know there's other views from other agents, because believe you me, I have heard them, had them communicated to me over the last few days, and I do appreciate the frustrations. And I hope that this time next week we'll be in an even better place than where we are today. In terms of those that have completed their forms, it is fair to say that 50-odd farmers have fully completed their forms. Another 500-plus are partially completed their forms, because many of them want to wait until the printing facility is available before they finally submit their online application. As I said also before, in the first couple of weeks, as is always the case every year, there's a slow uptake of people filling in their single application forms online. and then it gets faster as the deadline gets closer. So we'll certainly monitor that very, very closely. And of course, in terms of some of the wider issues, we're also monitoring them very, very closely as well, and we'll take appropriate action as and when required.
Liam MacArthur.
Thank you very much, Deputy President. Officer, the Cabinet Secretary has referred to the various options available to farmers. You'll be aware that in the constituency I represent, obviously, access to broadband is far from universal. And indeed, many of the farmers are based out in some of the smaller islands, and therefore even accessing the area office presents a logistical challenge. I welcome any comments you'd have about the specific support that may be available to them. And much has been made of the IT problems surrounding SAF, but certainly I'm getting the feedback from my constituents that the complexity of SAF is also a major problem. The Cabinet Secretary has pointed to the need to get this right, but to ensure payments get out in a timely fashion. Would it not be prudent in this first year to make sure that if we've only got 53 out of some 22,000 through the system already, that it looks pretty much inevitable that we're going to have to delay a month and get people prepared for that sooner rather than later?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, as I said, because of the complexity of the new policy, and one reason why there's complexities within the IT system is, of course, because the overall policy is complex, and every single member state has made strong representations to the new commissioner to simplify the new common agricultural policy, because all member states, all administrations are finding it pretty challenging to implement the new policy. Notwithstanding that, though, we do have a system up and running in Scotland, and many people are using it, and I'm confident more people will use it as the weeks go by. However, we will give serious consideration to extending the deadline by a month, but as I said in my previous response, there are other consequences we just have to take into account. We're currently discussing them with the industry, with the stakeholders, because we don't want to be in a position in a few months' time where we're getting complaints about payments being delayed because we delayed the deadline for the single application forms. So we just have to balance up all these considerations, but we are giving it serious thought.
John Scott.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. In declaring an interest as a farmer, the Cabinet Secretary will be aware of the frustration in the farming industry about the apparent lack of functionality in the new £100 million rural payments and services computer system. You will also be aware of the industry concerns about this problem, as farmers are required to lodge their application form before the 15th of May, less than 2 months away, and 99% of applicants have yet to use this new system at what is, for many, their most stressful time of year. Given the reported willingness of Commissioner Hogan to accept late applications, can the Cabinet Secretary tell Parliament how and if such delays will affect the timing of payments this year, should he need to take up Commissioner Hogan's offer to accept late applications?
Well, the complexity of the new policy that we're implementing in Scotland, and whilst a lot of the complexity has emanated from Europe, we did introduce some of our own after discussions with the industry to make sure the policy was appropriate for Scotland's diverse circumstances. That means that we have to be very careful about how we move forward and make sure the payments can be out in time if that's at all possible, because we always said to the industry this is a complex policy, it will be challenging to implement in Scotland with some of the decisions that have been taken, and that could have potential implications for the payments. And the industry's message back was, we don't mind the payments being a bit later if we get the right policy in place in the first place. However, at the moment, we're still scheduling issuing the payments on time in December, but if the extension for submitting the claims in the first place is extended by a month, clearly that gives us less time to carry out the inspections that have to be carried out before payments are actually made in December. So we have to balance up those challenges, and we're doing that at the moment. We're also discussing with the Commission if there will be more leeway over the inspections and the penalty regime as a result of extending the deadline for applications by a month. So that's where the discussions are at the moment. So I do take seriously many of the concerns expressed by members. I'm receiving daily reports from the IT team and the wider CAP implementation team to make sure we can fix any issues that come up as quickly as possible, and we get the new policy implemented in Scotland as smooth as possible, and then, of course, issue the vital payments to farm businesses across Scotland as soon as possible thereafter.
Thank you. That ends topical questions. The next item of business is a debate on motion number 12763 in the name of Hamza Yousaf,